Making things is honestly just the most fun in the world. It's good for stress, going through things, just all the different emotions. If you can work on something, it's the best feeling in the world once you get finished. I work down here as much as I can when I'm not working at my other jobs, but do as much as I can. It's the best thing in the world. It's not my full-time job. I don't know if it ever will be my full-time job because I like doing it when I like to do it, even if I can make money off of it. I just don't want it to become a career and not art for me. Hi, my name is Micah Reinhardt. I'm a machinist and kind of a jeweler. And I got into trying this because I saw a picture online and decided I wanted to try it. I have a small hobbyist lathe here. I make rings, jewelry, shift knobs, musical instruments, all my other machinery, wood carvings, functional objects, just anything I can get my hands on. If I had to name my best work, it's really, really hard question to make a lot of things. Probably the electric mandolin I made for a regional art show with my school, and I won that show out of the entire northeastern region of the United States, which is pretty cool. It was probably the most fun I've had working on something. So this is a chestnut oak. It's a burl rootwood that my grandpa cut down probably 20-25 years ago. He gave me a big piece of it. It's finished. It's one of my favorite things that I do. It's something I came up with. I take wood filler and mix it with a lot of water so it's very thin, and then I dye it, coat the whole thing, and then sand it back so that just the top grain's filled, but all of the imperfections in the wood are also filled. Something I'm pretty proud of. Kept a nice live edge. It's a hand-carved maple neck out of a piece of maple I had for another project. The fretboard inlays are colored pencils, which I love the detail of. It's not something I came up with, though. The headstock here is hand-carved. The weathering effect I like. It's just a whole lot of fun to make, and I drew the shape myself. So I started out machining on my grandpa's 13-inch South Bend 6-foot lathe, which is way overkill for what I was using it for. I was hollowing out quarters to make quarter rings, which is one of the first things I ever did, and it grew from there. Now I make shift knobs, I made full-size lightsaber hilts, I make a ton of rings, all sorts of material. I have lots of crazy titaniums and bronze just floating around here. Machining's a lot of fun. It's a little dangerous, but I like it. So the way I make rings now, it takes a good amount of equipment, a good amount of skill. You can't just get into it one day and start with that. But the way I started, I did it with a hammer, I think the back of an anvil on a metal vise, and a quarter. I made a ring by hammering around the edges, making it fold over, and then drilling out the center and polishing it with a Dremel. So I started it with zero experience, and that's where this all grew out of. I make tons of custom order high-end rings now. It all started with a hammer, a quarter, and an anvil, so really anyone can get into this. It just takes time and the enjoyment. Thanks for coming and checking out the workshop. My name is Micah Reinhardt, and this has been Artisan Authority.
Hey everybody, it's Liam. We're here with Jay, we're here with Dalton, and today we're watching an episode of Binging with KTV, and today's episode is Lovely Liam's Choice. We're going to go over a movie, a show, and my personal choice for a playlist of music that I think you guys will have a great time listening to. Let's get into it.
Well, for one, the costume design was insanely good.
Beautiful.
For sure. The actors overall were amazing.
I was like shocked because when it first came out, I had heard not so great things about it. And then like watching it, I was like, what are these people talking about? I was like, this is amazing.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think on top of the transitions, I think the movie overall tells a really surprisingly dark story for how uplifting and how bright and colorful the movie may be, like scenery-wise, costume design.
Yeah.
I also think what's really interesting about the film is that, like, when you watch it and if you really pay attention, you can see that, like, the songs that they pick out specifically play a significant part in the actual story.
Yeah.
Where each song has a dark tone and a dark theme to it. So, like, I don't want to go into spoilers, but the song Rocket Man itself, the song Rocket Man, is used in a very surprisingly upsetting scene, which shows how a character like Elton John is used in the music industry, basically like a vessel, like a puppet, and he's just thrown back out on stage like he's nothing, which I think was overall shocking, amazing, but then at the same time really, really, you know, unfortunate. You may think they had the high life, but these movies definitely show a dark side to their career and show how there is a struggle that they go through.
I really like the transition of Elton John's character in the movie, too.
So overall, I give it, like, 10 out of 10. I think it's actually really cool because it definitely, it flips the script. It talks about the, you know, the antagonist, now protagonist, of his own story. Years later, after this, you know, big event, this cult following movie, it's an American classic, and to see the show kind of adapt its own theme of humor, heartfelt moments, great storytelling, it definitely stands on its own as its own thing, while still pertaining to the original Karate Kid message of, you know, which was, you know, self-defense, karate, being a badass at the same time, you know.
For the people who wrote Cobra Kai and, like, are producing Cobra Kai, that was a smart move for them.
And I like the fact that it's told from, you know, Johnny Lawrence's view rather than another, like, continuation of Daniel LaRusso's.
I think another thing too with the Cobra Kai show is that with the story, they definitely mix, you see like the different culture viewpoints of the kids and the adults in the show, and how they kind of clash with each other sometimes in a way. I think it's actually pretty funny, and it's done very well. Like, they make Johnny Lawrence look like he's a freaking caveman, and he has no idea how the modern world works. And I think it's the funniest thing, and he's like so behind on, you know, up-to-date stuff, and then these kids are throwing at him like all this stuff he needs to know, and he's like, screw that, be a badass, do karate, it's like the coolest shit. And I just think that's awesome. I think that's the funniest thing. It's not the best show, but I think it's really funny, it's entertaining, it definitely passes the time by. I'm obviously pulled into it, and it's also because of the show that I now own 2 Cobra Kai t-shirts and a hoodie. But I guess the floor is mine now, because today we are going to do Liam's choice for music. I think the most recent thing I've been binging on Spotify, specifically on my playlist, would be an early 2000s pop list. I definitely find myself bobbing to early 2000s sometimes, especially when I'm in the car, driving to work, driving home, going to the grocery store. I find myself going crazy with Black Eyed Peas, Farish Movement, you know, I got all those bands. I got Early Maroon 5. I got all those good bands. I think everyone should check out this playlist that I'm going to show you right now. Definitely go through it, go down the list, and I think you guys will have a really good time. It's definitely a big nostalgic throwback, especially for people who were born in the late 90s, early 2000s. You've just been watching Binging with KUTV. I'm Liam. That's Dolan. This is Jade. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you next week.
everybody. This is Scoop from KTV, and this is What's Scoop, Bruh? This is September 12th, 2020, and we're going to go out into the streets of Kutztown and interview people and get the scoop on all the hottest topics such as the Rona and the election. We're, of course, practicing social distancing with our masks, so let's do this. Excuse me, would you like an interview? An interview, sir. We're interviewing people. Who are you?
My name's Mark.
Clark?
Yeah.
How are you today, Clark? November's coming up, the 2020 election. Do you have an idea who you're voting for?
Oh, yeah. Not for either.
You guys want an interview? You guys want an interview? Want an interview? What's going on, guys? We're interviewing random people in the streets of Kutztown. Would you like to be a part of an interview?
We're kind of busy.
Oh, it looks like you're almost done.
Well, we gotta keep. We have like 11 more pads to do. Kind of don't work.
We're interviewing people in the street. Sir, I need an interview. What's your opinion on separation of church and state? Strong, silent type. No. No. Ah, what's your name?
Lauren.
Lauren, what's the scoop, bro?
What's the scoop?
Yeah.
I'm heading to work at Grab and Go.
Can you do a kickflip?
No.
So, oh God. I'm doing this with a microphone in hand. That's it, I'm going crazy. No, that's not gonna work. Scoop, bro.
What's the scoop? I graduated 7 years ago. I come back here for the food and the photos of it's my car right there.
Oh, wow. Favorite thing to take photos of?
My car. My car.
Do you think lizard lives matter?
Always.
What's your views on Joe Biden?
I will not say.
What's your views on Donald Trump?
I will not say.
Do you think Joe Biden is a White Claw or a Truly guy? Excuse me, sir. We're doing interviews with people we find on the street. Would you like to do an interview? What's your name, bud?
My name's Shaggy.
Shaggy, what are you doing here, bud?
Just hanging out, enjoying the day, smoking a cigarette.
What's your preferred cigarette?
Marlboro Red, actually. Smoke Marlboro Reds, every day, pretty much. Two packs a day.
Two packs a day? Why not make it four?
What if I had the money?
What does most of your money go towards? What's your opinion on COVID-19?
It's a hoax, Democratic hoax.
You think Joe Biden is one of the lizard people trying to take over?
Yes, absolutely. He blinks sideways. You got a cousin who was at the rally, said he saw him blink sideways.
Okay,